You've probably heard of Vanta Black, one of the darkest coatings ever developed. But what about the whitest white? Well, researchers at Purdue University have developed what is being dubbed the whitest paint. More than bragging rights, the paint has the potential to reduce energy consumption by reflecting sunlight back into space to more effectively cool buildings and structures.
The reduction in the absorption to the solar radiation is a key. So if you put both commercial white paint and our paint surfaces outside under the sun, and our paint, you know, if you touch it with your finger, it's cool to the touch. In the best kind of weather, it can even cool below the ambient temperature. So, but if you touch the commercial white paint, well, if you touch the surface painted with commercial white paint, it will be still warmer than the ambient. So it feels warm. And while ours is cool to the touch.
Air conditioning and electric fans account for around 10% of global energy consumption, with global demand expected to triple by 2050. The United States expressing its concerns over ongoing reclamation projects in Manila Bay. In a statement, the U.S. Embassy in Manila said it is worried over the project's link to a Chinese firm that's China Communications Construction Company that's been blacklisted in the U.S. for its role in constructing and militarizing artificial islands in the disputed West Philippine Sea. It adds the Chinese company also has been flagged by the World Bank and the Asian Development Bank for engaging in fraudulent business practices. Two of the six approved reclamation projects in Manila Bay are being carried out by one of the units of the Chinese firm. The embassy is currently in talks with the Philippine government about issues with the possible long-term and irreversible impacts of the projects on the environment. British car distributor Inchcape acquiring 60% of Katz Motors Philippines. That was a news 7 months ago. Well, the ball is rolling. The joint venture marks the London-based giant's entry into the Philippine market and the 11th expansion in the Asia-Pacific region. Katz Philippines distributes luxury cars like Mercedes-Benz, Chrysler, and Dodge. In a press release, the Ang family-owned distributor said they will benefit from Inchcape's global knowledge, digital expertise, and EV know-how. This comes amid a growing luxury vehicle market in the Philippines. In other news, Metro Pacific Tollway's newly opened NLEX-SLEX connector gets the green light from the Toll Regulatory Board to begin collecting starting Tuesday next week, August 8th. This stretches between Caloocan C3 and España Boulevard in Manila. Class 1 vehicles, including cars and SUVs, will be charged 86 pesos, while minivans and buses under Class 2 will pay 215 pesos. Large trucks and trailers will be charged 302 pesos. Now, the NLEX-SLEX connector section 1 has been catering to over 14,000 motorists daily since it opened in March, while NLEX is targeting to complete section 2, which spans España to Santa Mesa, by fourth quarter of this year. This should benefit those within the university belt. Now, the Marcos administration's proposed 5.76 trillion peso national budget for next year. Now with Congress, education and public works set to get the biggest shares in the budget that the administration says is intended to help secure a future-proof and sustainable economy. RG Cruz gives us a breakdown in this report.
The House of Representatives has received from the Department of Budget and Management the proposed 5.768 trillion peso national budget for 2024, which rose by about 10% from this year. Huge portions of the budget will go to social services, but there's also money for debt servicing and defense. Large chunks of the budget were also allocated to education, public works and highways, health, interior and local government, national defense, transportation, social welfare and development, agriculture and agrarian reform, judiciary, labor and employment, and migrant workers. There's also money for national health insurance, free college tuition, and higher pension for indigent seniors, flood control and unemployment assistance. Social protection, popularly known as ayuda, will continue even after the end of the public health emergency.
The total funding for major social programs under the proposed 2024 budget is 598.7 billion. Parang wala pong discontinued of all the projects. We will continue yung 4Ps natin. And in fact, may additional program tayo. Ito po yung walang gutom yung food stamp program under DSWD. And we also still provided yung transport voucher under DOTR and Department of Agriculture. Meron pa rin po yun, tigpa 500 million pesos if I'm not mistaken.
About 10 billion pesos have been allotted for surveillance, confidential, and intelligence funds, most of which are under the Office of the President. However, the Office of the Vice President, Department of Education, and Department of Agriculture also have their share. Aside from the Department of Interior and Local Government, which supervises the Philippine National Police, and the Department of National Defense, which has oversight on the armed forces.
Alam niyo po, yung confidential and intel funds, meron naman pong guidelines yan from COA on how to use the funds. Hindi naman po siya budget na parang pagkabigay, they can actually disburse it and use it. Meron din pong dokumento na sinasubmit po sa COA, and then may breakdown din po yan when we request the budget. So it's not, there's full transparency po in terms of the request for these funds.
The overall budgets of the Office of the President and the Office of the Vice President also got bumped up while Congress took a budget cut. But bigger increases went to other agencies.
First major increase in our budget is under the Department of Transportation. We almost doubled the budget of DOTR. The second is, of course, because mataas po yung increase ng Department of Agriculture this year, 30% po yung naging increase niya this year. So for next year, we increased it again to another 6%. This should. There's been a big increase under the DSHUD para po doon sa programa nila na pabahay. It's we have 9 billion pesos in the National Expenditure Program.
Albay Representative Edsel Lagman reminds his colleagues they are empowered to modify the budget. House Speaker Martin Romualdez wants to get the budget done and over with in the next couple of months.
With everyone's participation and cooperation, I'm confident that the House of Representatives will be able to scrutinize, deliberate, and pass a national budget that is pork barrel free for 2024 before we go on our first recess in October.
The House will begin budget deliberations on August 10. RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.
Back to more news here at home. The Senate Blue Ribbon Committee calling out alleged irregularities at the National Irrigation Administration. As Ada Perez tells us, these include decades-long unfinished projects and funding requests for the maintenance of stalled works. Take a look.
Rinaldo from Tribong Abiling was 18 years old when the construction of Balugbalug Dam started in their area in Tarlac. He is now 57 years old, and this project of the National Irrigation Administration remains unfinished.
So actually, wala pa pong nangyayari sa Balugbalug Dam. At sa totoo lang po, yung Balugbalug Dam na sinasabi ay may pondo ng 13.37 bilyon. Pero ang ginawa po lang nila, pinagbabakbak lang yung kalikasan namin, kinabunan po nila ng mga sagradong lugar. Yung mga pangako nila na nasa provision ng mga ay halos hindi pa po may patupad. Nung una po, sigasig po silang nagbibigay ng kabayaran ng aming mga plan damages, yung aming mga disturbance compensation. Bandang ini, pinahirapan na po yung aking mga tao dahil marami na po silang hinahanap na dokumento.
Senator Raffy Tulfo said the Balugbalug Dam project goes way back from the time of former President Corazon Aquino. It was intended to provide year-long irrigation for more than 34,000 hectares in 10 municipalities to benefit 23,000 farmers.
Ito po ang litrato ng OCLA inspection namin sa Balugbalug. Ayan po, makikita nyo. Ito po ang itsura ng 12 billion pesos. Ayan ang itsura ng 12 billion pesos na proyekto na hanggang ngayon ay nakatiwangwang. Ang nakakatawa po po dyan ay ginagastusan ito ng 50 million pesos a year sa repair and maintenance. Hindi pa nga po tapos and yet may 50 million pesos para sa maintenance. Ulitin ko po, 50 billion pesos na nagastos
at nakatiwang mo at hindi pa tapos. E 50 million pesos para sa maintenance. Anong i-maintain? Ang mga bulsa?
Nia explained the project has been terminated with its former contractor.
Bumalik po kasi kami sa NEDA dahil may mga change sa may pinalit change of scope po yung trabaho. And then malapit na naman pong ipa-rebid po ulit ito. Within siguro ang target namin sir is around mga October siguro.
Can you confirm na 20% lang yung completion?
Well, ang ma-confirm ko lang po.
After 5 decades?
Nung tinignan ko po, mahigit pa pong 5 billion yung natitirang pondo. Enough naman po ito para tapusin yung high dam natin.
But lawmakers ask, why do unfinished projects need a maintenance budget? Nia officials provided different answers.
Pagkakaalam ko po kasi, yung mga maintenance na yon, meron na po mga to upkeep yung mga irrigation facilities na mga na-complete po nila. No? May mga partially na ginagamit na po kasi. Yung phase 1 po, sir, ginagamit po.
Yung pong kabuuan ng allocation ng project, hindi po yan ibinibigay ng one time. Hindi po yan pang-maintain. Yan pong mga requirement na every year allocation ng mga multi-year project.
Aside from Balog-Balog Dam, Tulfo said there are other unaccomplished projects like the 990 million peso Bulo Small Reservoir Irrigation Project in Bulacan, 650 million peso Marime Project in Apayao, and 800 million peso Dumulok Project in Pangasinan. Another issue touched on by the Senate panel is Bustos Dam, which is also a project of NIA. The Bulacan Provincial Government is citing water released from the dam as one of the reasons for flooding in the province. Local officials say they were not advised that the dam will release water.
Diversion dam po siya. Rubber type dam po siya. So kailangan po talagang ibaba yun, sir, kapag ka umaapaw na. Kasi masisira po yung dam natin.
Kung hindi rubber yon, medyo hindi babagsak yon.
Kung hindi po siya rubber, magbubukas po sila ng mga gates. So ilalabas pa rin po yung tubig, sir. Hindi po siya reservoir type dam.
Saan galing naman yung tubig niya?
Again, nag-release po ang ipo ng 100 cubic meters per second.
At least one lawmaker sees possible charges arising from the string of unfinished projects by NIA.
Katapos itong hearing, ipaglalabang ko na may makukulong. May makasuan, may makukulay.
The Senate is set to conduct more hearings on the issue. Ara Perez, ABS-CBN News.